And welcome to EA Pro Planning with another planning tutorial. Today we're looking at the timeline. So we're going to go ahead and jump right in here to the Plan My Event. This is set up for a DJ ceremony and reception. If your event is different, don't worry, the concepts are the same. And your account most likely came standard with a timeline kind of lined up for your event as just an example to give you some ideas. So every timeline has three main pieces. We have our time column, our activity column, and our comments column. The time column is simply when something happens, the activity column is what's going to happen, and the comments column is how is it going to happen. So looking at our existing timeline, we see what's gonna happen, dinner, when's it gonna happen, 7:35, and how's it gonna happen. It's buffet style and caterers are releasing tables. The how is important because that tells me how to instruct guests. Once we start planning our time column, that's when we start thinking about event flow. So event flow is looking at how much time an activity consumes and then deciding if that amount of time is appropriate. In other words, is this gonna feel like a drag or is this gonna feel smooth? It's important to have things that will re-engage your guests throughout the evening. So the easiest time for guests to de-engage is between dinner and our open dance. My rule of thumb is to never let this time gap be more than 2 hours. It's better if it can be shorter, but depending on how many guests you have, it's not always possible. But there are things we can do along the way to re-engage guests. So the way I have it set up on this example is we have our dinner beginning at 7:35, and then as soon as the last table is served or the last table goes through the buffet line, we move on to our toast. So this means that some people are still eating, but the important piece is anyone who got their food first and maybe finished eating now has something to do, to listen to the toast. Furthermore, we follow this toast by the shoe game, which allow those people who are still eating more time to eat. And then we move on to the cutting of the cake. Then I allowed a small gap for guests to get their dessert before we move on to the first dance. And this way we keep the different activities happening pretty fast, so there's no huge gap for guests to get unengaged. So those are a few things to think about when planning the timeline. For the sake of the tutorial, I'm gonna go ahead and erase a few lines here and show you guys kind of how the timeline editor works. So on the right hand side here, we have these different controls and I'm using the X button right now just to clear out lines. So you can use that just to wipe out an entire line. So now we have some space, okay? So here we have options that are gonna correspond with the type of event you have. So since this is a ceremony and reception, we have ceremony options and reception options down here. And any option you click will add to the next available line unless you click and drag that option to a line that you want it in. So you can control where it goes like that. So it makes it really easy to quickly populate the list. Of course, you can also type in a custom message in any of these lines too. When first using the timeline editor, these up and down arrows over here can feel somewhat confusing. The down arrow creates space above the line you click on. So if we just realize, oh, we forgot the bride's processional above the opening remarks, I can come over here to the opening remarks line and click down. And then creates the space there. I can come over here, click bride's processional, and it's in. So it allows you to move things around really easily. And then also the blue arrows on the side here allow you to move lines to any line that you would like. So there's a few tips and tricks there for planning your timeline. If you need any more help on it, just give me a holler. Of course, I'm always happy to help out.